Good morning from Puna, Hawaii. The big ancient lava flow coming down from Mauna Loa here on the outskirts of Volcano National Park.
So here's my Sunday market. Basically, it's a restaurant, and they rent out to the people that the Pamela produce. She comes through here and on Sundays, and she lines up everything. So there it is, all this incredible produce. So I hit it every Sunday morning, and where I get my stuff. Okay, this is today's take from the market. Lettuce, kale, longans, big mushrooms, star fruit, onions, tomatoes. This is spinach. This is cilantro, asparagus, corn. What else? Anything else in here? I guess that's it. 38 pounds of bananas. A couple avocados, rambutans, sprouts, lettuce, papayas, limes. One thing I didn't get was citrus. Oh, there's some citrus. Cool. thanks, sir. Yeah, so now I got citrus, but there's a lot of citrus around. You can kind of just stop by the side of the road and pick some off, you know. But that's what it looks like today. Not bad. And the cost, this entire bit for the week was $160. Wow. So here's what you should be eating for breakfast. High density sweet fruit. Bananas. Or some such thing. Something like this, lilikoi. Woo! 5 times the vitamin C of an orange, 1 lilikoi. I'm putting 2 in here. So I'm eating 10 oranges worth of vitamin C. So far this morning, I've had a couple of oranges. Some cilantro. I'm gonna put a big, almost half the thing in there. Actually, cilantro, there's more nutrients in the stems than there is in the leaves. Quite a bit more, actually. So I'm gonna go with the stems this time. Let's put the stems in and a few leaves. Chop them up pretty good. Dump them in there. I'll take about half of this, leave some cilantro left over for making salsa, and pop that in there. So that's almost probably 2/3 of a bunch of cilantro. Let's see. Yeah, so I'm not going to do kale this morning. I'm just doing cilantro, lilikoi, and bananas. Simple, easy to digest. No chia seeds or protein powder or any of that crap. You don't want any of that stuff in the morning. You want good, pure, clean energy. So I'm going to blend this up on my $5 $5 thrift store blender. Not for very long, like, you know, 30, 45 seconds. And the reason for that is I'm going to do it a little more because I can see the bananas didn't really get blended. So what I got here is, see the green particles? That's the cilantro. So you know the fiber's still in there. The fact is that when you blend something, you're destroying the fiber. So bananas, you know, I probably destroyed all the fiber in the bananas, right? The thing about that is bananas don't have a lot of fiber to begin with, okay? So you're, you know, sure you compromise the fiber a little bit, but, you know, it's not that big of a deal. But I still have the cilantro intact. The lilikoi is like a gel, so I don't think it harmed the lilikoi too much, right? So, yeah, this is what I'm going to eat for the rest of the day, or for the rest of the morning. I'll have some snacks. Let's see, once upon a time I had a jar. I'll just put some in this glass. So yesterday I had similar thing, only I used kale. And then I ran off, I rode 6.5 miles to the beach. I carted my bike down a volcanic cliff. I did about 45 minutes of intense yoga. I did 50 push-ups. I went swimming for about 45 minutes in the ocean, body surfing. Then I rode the 6.5 miles back. All right, that's the kind of stuff that bananas are made of.
So anyways, what I'm going to do is run a backing track. Just to give you a little example of some of the things you got to do to prepare for a gig like this. Doing you know, 8 or 9 Stevie Ray Vaughan songs, and 8 or 9 Clapton songs, and 10 or 11 Tom Petty songs, and 7 or 8 of my original songs. And so that's what I'm going to be doing tonight. Tonight I'm going over the Petty stuff, you know. In an Indiana town, had a good little mama who never was around. And she grew up tall and she grew up right. From Indiana boys on an Indiana night. Oh. So all that kind of good stuff. I'll be learning some leads, you know. And so forth. So that'll be fun. And I've got what? I've got tonight and I've got tomorrow to do that stuff, to get ready, make sure I've got all my ducks in a row. And anyways, that's that. And I will tune back in maybe tomorrow, tell you where I am on my preparation. And then on Thursday, we'll do the rehearsal. We'll go up. It's actually not too far from here. Once again, I'm out on the lava. I'm at the base of the I'm living on the borderline of Volcano National Park. And the most active volcano in the world is about, I'd say, 7 or 8 miles from here, Mauna Loa. Last time it erupted was about 6 months ago, and it all went north. But this is an area that was covered by lava maybe 20 years ago. Wiped out a whole town and a whole village and everything. And people have come back and built on the lava. You can buy a bus, park it on a piece of property, and build a roof around it. Or you can go like there in the distance. You can do a fancy-dancy house that looks like it's from suburban LA. Or you can build a two-story like that one right there. Or you can get yourself a big bulldozer and bulldoze some land and put up these huge, huge greenhouses. And I do believe those are full of plants right now. They're big old greenhouses. The lava flows are moving north, so it's very unlikely anything's going to come down here. You know, certainly not in the near future. So today's the day of rehearsal. At 4:30 in about 6 hours, and I'm starting to get ready, get my act together. I've decided to check out my Les Paul, which has two humbucking pickups, which are a lot more powerful for the Petty stuff, for the Tom Petty stuff, since I don't have a lead guitarist playing. And I'm just playing rhythm. I mean, I'm going to be playing lead as well. And I think I need an extra beefy tone for the leads on the Petty stuff. And this, by the way, is I cut the tip of my finger the other day. Can you believe it? Right before a rehearsal, or, you know, right before a gig. So I cut the tip of my finger, and I found these things in the drugstore. They're finger protectors, right? So I put a It's not a deep cut or a bad cut, but it's just in the right, you know, in a spot where you use that as a pivot. See how it's a pivot? So you put a lot of pressure on that finger, and the cut is kind of at the side. So I put a piece of tape with a little bit of tiny bit of toilet paper as a padding, and then I put this over it. It seems to work. It worked last night when I was practicing. So, see how that sound is? It's fuller, you know, it's got more body. Generally speaking, if you want notes to sing, you want to play something like a Les Paul, which is a double, has the double coil pickups, humbucking pickups. Of course, you can't really tell at this volume, but it does make notes sing out. A Stratocaster is a thinner sounding guitar. And a telly, like they use in country music, is a very thin sounding. It's a very unique sound. Some people use it for rock and roll and blues. So you can hear that. That's a beefy sound. That's a real beefy sound. Get an idea. I know this is technical stuff for guitar players, but I don't know, you might find it interesting. Which you see, it has two single coil pickups. So I'm gonna test that out. Thank you.
nice sound. I mean, I'm not hearing that much difference. I thought I'd hear a lot more, but there is a little less bass. So if I'm playing a lead. This is a Fender Hot Rod Deluxe.
It's a tube amp.
So it has that warm body, full body sound. It's a very good amp. I'm really pleased with it. I'm using a Boss pedal board, which is not quite as effective as using individual pedals. I don't think it's not as convenient. So that's what I'm using today. Okay. Just turned off the main drag, if you want to call it that. It's also a two-lane road. Now I'm cruising through a very rural part of Hawaii. East side of the Big Island, about 6 miles from the nearest town. And it's pretty nice out here. A lot of dense vegetation. Traffic. We're going all the way to the end. Video steam. So I remember he said there was a lot of steam up here. So this is what it looks like. This is the gate. And looks like he's got a little steam bed waiting for him out here. It's kind of interesting. After all, we are on the border of Volcano National Park, with the most active volcano in the world, Mauna Loa. So here's the gate, gonna wait here.
So, like apparently all the heat from the steam, you know, kills a lot of the vegetation. So, we got all these trees that are dead. I'm not sure. It must be the heat that kills them, kills their roots or something. There's a palm tree back there that made it. Anyways, we're up here in volcano land. Looking pretty interesting. Here is an actual steam vent. It's coming out of that, beneath that rock right there. So all down below the topsoil, which, by the way, takes 300 years to actually form. So all the vegetation you see here, it's in a couple inches of soil that was formed over 300 years, you know, after a volcano eruption came through. It's kind of an interesting process. You know, because little seeds, grass seeds and stuff accumulate in the rocks of the molten, of the frozen lava. And they grow little plants, and then the plants shed their leaves. And then those leaves eventually become...
We're going through the gate. I'm going to be the last one. And apparently the driveway is pretty challenging. So one of us... Tate, the bass player, is going to have to park off to the right and jump on somebody else's vehicle and make it up to the top. Anyways, pretty amazing. Look at this soil. Steamy.
That's kind of interesting. There's a house. Looks like it's been abandoned. Maybe because of the lava and the steam.
So we're making the transfer. This is what rehearsal and... On the east side of the island of Hawaii and the rural district of Puna can turn into. Test one, two. So here we go. We're going up. There's somebody's house. Rural Hawaii. So we're going up this steep old hill. I'm going to get a running start. Two pieces of concrete.
to the concrete strips of them and laid down, apparently to give me traction. So we're going all the way up. Oh, to the end. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Wow, this is an adventure. Holy shit. Oh, here it is. All right, rehearsal. So we made it to the top, and this is what it looks like. Over there, that must be Mauna Loa, or one of the craters or something, huh? Those definitely look like craters. I don't know if they're active ones.
This is at my friend Dave Ewing's house. It was
pretty amazing.
When his...
Check it out. Went down to my car. So we'll actually be rehearsing outdoors. Check it out, that's Mauna Loa. The furthest volcano, the furthest mountain you see is Mauna Loa, which is the active volcano. Yeah, what a view, huh? Check it out.
I said, screw that, I'm going to call the play that I called. And the play I called scored a touchdown. But he benched me because I'm teaching. And I'm like going, what you're showing me is shit.
Yeah.
You're a terrible guy. You know,
Yeah, you know, but I'd lose them. Well, what happened? I had three gigs in a row.
You
cannot do that. I got to hey, take it easy.
Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, right. It's hard to say no when.
Nah, dude, that's especially for the gig.
Yeah.
I got to prime up for the gig. And then plus my friend, this friend of mine gave me 45 cookies. 45 cookies.
Oh, yeah,
a whole fucking bag.
Those are too strong for me.
My wife did that. She made 3 tinfuls of chocolate chip cookies. They're from basically the Mrs. Fields recipe. And so, no nuts anymore. We kept the tin. One tin went to her work, and one tin went to my work.
No, I just think we need to get some rest. That's all. You know.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing all week.
Like a quarter of a cookie, and that's good. And when I get up, I'm like, oh, I'm stretching. I can tell I rested. Thank you, brother.
Yeah, this whole week for me too is just
love that sound on this.
No, all the work I got in front of me. Time out.
Yeah. Exactly. Dude, I got tons of work.
It's great.
Yeah.
It reminds me of.
Yeah, no, I could go for months and months. No.
This video, but as you can see, you got a lot going on and you can't always take the time or be aware of the fact that your viewfinder is limited. So it's not just that I want to show myself. I'd rather see the whole band, but anyways, you'll get an idea of what's going to do.
We're going to the verse.
Yeah.
We
can
go solo. And then what? We're going out?
There'll be another verse and a chorus after that, and then we'll go out.
Okay, so let's do the verse. He's going to do the solo.
Yeah, why don't you just do the solo and all that?
And then do the
verse and out.
No.
Chorus and out.
Yeah, do the turnaround and out. That way I can examine all the three sections, right?
Oh, okay, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Right? I think I got it.
Solo is the verse, and then chorus and out.
Out, okay.
Yeah, because all your songs are so close.
Yeah.
That you need a computer science to an AI to go like which one now, right? and then the firing squad comes out with the kind of goofy guns with all the webs and shit.
Start over. Right? Start over.
All right.
They are kind of similar, sir.
Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I got a, because I was so run down, I was eating sunflower seeds and nuts, and one got jammed up in my gum, in my back molar.
Oh shit.
And the thing got impacted.
Oh no.
Because my immune system was down.
Right.
I got the fever and everything. That was like, that night when we was playing, I go, yeah. I don't know if I can come to practice. Well, the next day I was like, oh fuck. My whole mouth was swollen. So I did oregano oil with DMSO, cotton swabs, and went up in there, and that kind of knocked them back a little bit. Yeah. But still, I had to rehydrate and everything. I got golden seal, hot golden seal tea with lemon, and then I did that for 2 days, and that kind of like bring it back down.
Oh,
so,
good.
And then I pulled up. So now I'm almost normal. I can grab my molder and do this, and it's not like,
Oh, shit. Man. Is it the thing is not still up there, is it?
No, it's okay now.
Oh, no. Wow.
But you know, it's going to take a little while for the golden seal to get in your system. Right?
Yeah.
I would do it early in the morning, right? Yeah. Before I eat and everything else. But you got to eat.
I take echinacea to get well.
Eat and rest, yeah.
You don't go to pharmacy to get well. You eat to get well.
I know.
The pharmacy to get well is the pharmacy is just make sure you stay sick.
Then it goes in your soul.
Okay,
so it's
what's the first part?
First break is C G C D. Goes to E B. Yeah, go back. Right there.
Then we go quiet.
No, there's a solo for like 4 measures. So. So we went ahead and did the gig on the next evening, and it went pretty well. Unfortunately, our video did not turn out at all. So I got no video of the gig. The drummer or the keyboard player took some video, but it just didn't come out, and the sound sucks. So, but that's the way it goes when you're performing and you're trying to cover the visual aspect. You make lots of mistakes. It's better to have somebody else independently doing that. We'll be right back.
We're the Lava Breakers. We got Steve Goodfarm on piano, Dave Bowman on guitar, Dave Walker on the bass, and my good friend Dave Ewing on the drums. Let's hear it for it. The Lava Breakers, thank you.
And T-Ray on vocals.
Yeah, I'm T-Ray, I'm up front here. Stick around, because the Shack Band's coming up.
Oh, are they?
You don't want to miss them.